Hi, I'm Rosa. My family just finished dinner, and it's my night to wash dishes. My dad told me, "All right, Cinderella, you're up." I knew exactly what he meant. That's a lot of dishes. When my dad called me Cinderella, he was making an allusion. Writers sometimes use these too. An allusion is a reference to a significant literary, historical, religious, or cultural person, place, event, or statement. Some allusions are from other works of literature, called sources. A source is an existing text on which an author draws to create a new work of literature. For instance, when my dad called me Cinderella, the source of the allusion was the fairy tale Cinderella. Remember, in the story, Cinderella's mean sisters make her do all the housework. Poor Cinderella. One important source in Western literature is the Bible. In the Bible, you can find many familiar archetypes. An archetype is a character, situation, or symbol that represents something universal, like the hero. One example of a villain archetype from the Bible is the serpent that tempted Eve to taste the forbidden fruit in the book of Genesis. By using sources like the Bible as inspiration and including archetypes and allusions, authors can create deeper levels of meaning in their work. In fact, the Bible's book of Genesis, chapters 1 to 3, has had a powerful effect on Western literature and has inspired many writers. For instance, John Steinbeck uses Genesis as a source in his novel East of Eden. In fact, the first allusion to Genesis is the title, East of Eden. The Garden of Eden is a paradise, the place where Adam and Eve lived. They were the first human beings, according to the story in Genesis. So even before you read the novel, you can guess from the title that Steinbeck is going to make allusions to the book of Genesis from the Bible. And you'd be right. In the Bible, Adam and Eve ignore God's law, and God banishes them from Eden forever. Something similar happens in Steinbeck's novel. Steinbeck isn't the only writer inspired by the book of Genesis, chapters 1 to 3. Many other important works of Western literature, from Milton's Paradise Lost to The Gilded Sixpence by Zora Neale Hurston, tells stories of loss of innocence and of being forced to leave a paradise. I bet you can think of some stories like that. Now it's time for me to get inspired. This Cinderella's got some dishes to wash.